Hello and welcome back to another edition of Interdreamteam. It's game week 34 and I'm joined by my old cronies, Mr. Coley and Mr. Settle. How's it going, fellas?
All right, boy.
Fantastic. Yeah. So it's Wednesday night at time of recording. No English teams left in the Champions League, so we haven't got to worry about those anymore. Just the two fixtures left to wrap up game week 33. And we won't have any stats or data from the Villa game and the Chelsea Spurs game in our spreadsheets this week. So big week, guys. Big week. Arsenal kept the pressure on City with that flying start in the North London derby and then allowed Spurs to come creeping back in. Did you see that picture doing the rounds on socials of that guy with the Odegaard shirt and the Son shirt?
Yes. Yeah, that's
that is disgusting. what is happening?
Awful, awful Batman.
Bad stuff.
he should have been dragged out of there by his short and curlies. Newcastle made it 13-1 in the aggregate score against Sheffield United. In the process, confirmed the inevitable. The Blades are down. And if you want McBurnie in, now's the time to do it because you can't have him next season. All right?
Unless Man United sign him.
So it's a free horse race. It's a free horse race for the other two relegation spots, guys. Forest in 17, Luton in 18, and Burnley in 19th. There's 2 points between them. Three games to go. Do you want to take a punt? Who's going down?
I don't think the positions will change.
Yeah,
Forest to sneak up. Yeah?
Forest to sneak out just. I think they're going to pick up some more points, which will sink the other two.
What juicy looking final day fixture there. Forest versus Burnley.
Cool.
All right, guys. Well, let's get into it. Let's talk about some strikers. And I'll get us started then, should I? So, Mr. Number One transfer for the week, Haaland. Disappointingly, only managed 28 minutes this game week. For the ones of us who stuck with him, we was hoping that he was going to get the full 90 because he came out of a lot of teams and that would have been quite the differential this week. But he looked good. 28 minutes, one goal, two shots. And 8 points for the game week. He's played Wolves three times and scored four goals. So decent returns against the boys in the old gold. Same can't be said for Salah. I know a lot of us got the leak, the last minute leak about Salah not starting, which was real handy because we were all torn, I think, between Salah and Haaland to bring in, to take out. But Salah, 11 minutes, 1 point, and an argument with a big German. So, not the best of weeks. No idea what was said, but didn't look friendly, did it?
No, certainly didn't.
Now, Salah is the number one most transferred out player for game week 33. And he's not on his own. He's got three of his Liverpool compatriots with him. So, Dream Team managers turning their backs on the Liverpool assets and probably rightly so. Now, as we said, Watkins goes again tomorrow night and that will complete his game week 33. Two shots on target and 4 points for the 2-2 draw against Chelsea at the weekend. And he's now at 37% owned. So, he's in most teams. And like I say, we'll all be hoping for a few more points tomorrow night. Yeah. He's going to be with us all for the remainder of the season, I think, isn't he? Watkins, with the fixtures they've got, you know, he's a stand and stay now, and hopefully he returns.
Yeah.
Now cast your minds back to the earlier part of the season, and Villa, they played Brighton and they beat them 6-1. Watkins bagged a hat trick and 2 assists that day, so we'll be hoping for a similar sort of return from him this week. When they go to the seaside. So, yeah, maybe most definitely captain's choice for this week. Isak had a great week, didn't he? 2 goals, 3 shots on target, and a very happy Ross who put him in for the Sheffield game. Yeah.
Cool, yeah.
Well played. Like,
right in the ghoulies.
I was hoping to get one more week out of not having him, but yeah, you've done all right there, mate. So here's a little something for you. Isak, last 5 games at St. James's Park, just the 8 goals.
Red hot.
And that's an average of 12.8 per game from the last 5 at St. James's Park, 12.8 points per game. So he's red hot at home. He loves it at home. Yeah. Big shout for this week. I know the fixtures aren't fully there, but, you know, single this week and double next week for Newcastle. So keep an eye on game week 35. And if you want, get him in, you know, because you're going to get him in next week anyway. So, you know, Burnley away, you know, could easily score well again. Right, just a quick word for Jackson. Anyone needing a boost and feeling lucky, look no further than Jackson. You know, he could probably fall into a barrel of titties and come out sucking a cock, but you know, he's got 5 fixtures left. He's got Spurs Thursday night in this game week, a very leaky Spurs defence. So, you know, there'll be chances there for him. And that'll give us a fair idea as to, you know, if it's someone that we might want to take a punt on. 3.4% owned, big differential. And, yeah, they've got West Ham at home this weekend. So, yeah. Maybe a Jackson if you need to make ground and you need to make a gamble, you know. There's only 4 game weeks left, guys. So, yeah, running out of time to have that gamble. So we've got Mateta. Look at him. Honourable mention for him. You know, probably not going to be going into our teams, but, you know, they've got Man United at home this weekend and he's 0.5% owned and he's another one who loves it at home. Last 5 home games, 7 goals for Mateta. He just loves to kick that corner flag at Selhurst Park, you know. So definitely going to get on the score sheet against Casemiro and Maguire, right?
Probably.
especially if his old pals Elise and Eze are on the pitch. So, yeah, once again, probably not going to be going in our teams, but, yeah, just a shout about Mateta. And Richarlison back from injury as well. He had, what, half an hour on the pitch at the weekend and looked all right. So he'll probably be starting, you'd have thought. Well, we'll get an idea tomorrow night, won't we, against Chelsea. But, yeah. Off to Anfield for Spurs. So, might be a very good time to play Liverpool. So, yeah, but there's your striker options, boys. Plenty to mull over. Now let's move down the pitch and have a look at the midfielders.
Yeah, I think it's an interesting one with the midfielders, because you're probably going to say, like, there's five midfielders there that are going to be in a really high percentage of teams. You think your Foden, Saka, Palmer, Fernandez, and then probably KDB. They're going to be in a lot of teams, but there's also going to be quite a few that are going to be looking at now bringing in three strikers. So you've got some tricky choices to make. There's not really a huge amount of new information on these. We all know how well Fernandez, Palmer, Saka, KDB have been performing, but there is some injury doubts, illness doubts over Foden. So that's one thing to watch. Obviously, a lot of rotation from Pep. There is a chance that Foden won't play at the weekend. Don't quite know how he's recovered. So that's definitely something to watch if you need to free up a space, because otherwise, you know, potentially if you have got five midfielders, like a lot of people have, you're going to be making a very difficult decision between the others. So you're looking for those little nuggets of information of who you can free up maybe to get that third striker in. I think some differential options. We've already spoken about the double game week for Newcastle next week, and you know, an attractive fixture against Burnley. Gimarais again performing really well, but you know, my eyes would be on Gordon. He is in some pretty decent form. He gets a lot of assists. He scores some goals, and I can see him, you know, suddenly popping up in a lot of teams during that double game week. So it depends how you want to plan for that, but that could be a choice to be made there. Because he is scoring well. I think it's a little bit, you know, you've got Gross on there. I don't think there's many arguments. So the midfields are so strong. I don't think there's a huge amount of argument to get somebody like that in there. And I also think if you're looking at a straight up choice between Odegaard and Saka, that's going to be difficult as well, isn't it? Saka is outscoring Odegaard, even though he is a class act and doing really well. And I think probably about now it's about worth time to get rid of the West Ham assets. I don't think that would be the best choice for the remainder of the season, even though they've done so well throughout the season. Despite, you know, Bowen picking up a little bit of form and not doing too bad, I just think they're not going to stand up to the competition at the moment. There's a lot of people who are going to have, like I said, four or five spine players, and not all going to be midfield players. So you're going to have to look premium and not go too mental. So I think, moving on from those obvious ones, we'll go on to the best of the rest. And the only real differentials you can look at for this particular game week are really the double game week players. There's only one team, and that's Villa. So similar to what we were indicating last week, there's some decent differentials here. If you just want to take that 1 week punt on, OK, well, I think Bailey is going to outscore KDB for 1 week because he's got two games. There's a decent enough argument to say that's possible over two games. He's doing decent, gets a lot of shots off, goals and assists. He's probably the pick, but also have a little look at Rodgers. Cheap, and not that that matters to a huge amount of managers at the moment, but he's hit some really good form. Considering where he's come from and how well he's settled in, he's clearly a talent, isn't he? Best mates with Cole Palmer as well, stolen his celebration. So, well, technically, Cole Palmer stole his celebration. Yeah. So there you go. Don't know if you saw that in the news. But I suppose for me, presuming that pretty much everyone's got KDB as the other one on this list, Havertz would probably be one of the premium differentials for this week for a similar reason, but just because he's on such good form. Look at the shots on him. He's a striker for Arsenal who are on really, really good form, being supported by Saka out on the right, Rice behind him, Odegaard pulling the strings, and he's essentially the striker. So it's not out of the question that he could notch a couple of times against Bournemouth at home in the early kickoff. So it's not the craziest idea to think that, if you want to be maybe thinking, right, actually, even someone like a Palmer and thinking, I just don't think he's going to score premium points this week, trying something different if the rest of your team's solid and strong and you're injury free. So for a little whistle stop tour of the midfielders, I think that's all there is to say. So keep it solid. And if you are going to go for a differential, don't go for two differentials. Just go for the one and don't go too mental. So let's move a little bit further back.
Right. Have a little look at the defender options. Going to be short and sweet. Yeah. Really, if you're looking to put a defender in for this game week, it's probably going to be Konsa, isn't it? Because they've got the double game week. He's been there in the rankings all season, sort of top 10, top 15, hitting all the metrics, plays regularly. The best Villa defender option to have, really, isn't he? And they've got five games, potentially six, if they make the Europa final. So, yeah, good option compared to the likes of, you know, you've got the Arsenal trio, obviously. Yeah, so the best of the rest. We've got a highlight, Gvardiol. The form has been incredible, actually. 61 points over the last five game weeks for him. So really impressive with his goals. And he's missed a game in that as well. So probably the best Man City option to get in. Five games left for them. Cash and Digne are both obviously Villa differentials for you if you want to go down that route. Cash has been pretty consistent throughout the season with his goals and assists, picking him up from right back. Does get rested occasionally. Digne attacking returns as well sometimes. Maguire, De Gea, the old Harry Maguire. We've got to highlight him, obviously. He's got a few goals recently against Coventry and Sheffield United. Obviously, no clean sheets, but yeah, they've got five games left. Tarkowski, I put him in because they've only got the three games. But very, very impressive clean sheets for Everton. He's got 13 clean sheets himself this season. Only the Arsenal contingent have got more than that. And they've got Luton coming up this game week. And then I think they've got Sheffield United the following game week. So they've got some nice little fixtures coming up there. So not a bad option if you want to go for a solid potential clean sheeter there. But let's have a little look at the keepers then, shall we, boys? Yeah, oh my God, Onana, look at that. It's terrible, isn't it? I mean, they have played, like I said, they played some quite easy opposition on paper. You know, you've got, where's my list here? You've got Bournemouth, Coventry, Sheffield United and Burnley. He's not kept a single clean sheet in any of them. So it's pretty woeful on his behalf there. I mean, Reyes, obviously, the king of the clean sheets, 18 clean sheets this season. Bit of a blip against Tottenham, but he turned it around. Martinez is an injury doubt, and they're saying he will be out of the game against Brighton, and he may return in the second leg of their Europa against Olympiacos next week, apparently. Pickford's an interesting one. Like we said, the Everton fixtures are decent. They've only got the three games, but the six goals he's conceded there were obviously just in that one game against the Chelsea, wasn't it? So, and Edison is back in training, so it wasn't a serious injury, so no need to probably transfer him out urgently. We have put the understudies Ortega on there and Olsen for Aston Villa as well, in case you want to go down that route. But enough about them. How's your old ticker, Sully?
Yeah, mate. So this is the fully set ticker for the rest of the season. No more editing of this ghastly spreadsheet. Yeah, as you can see, it's all there. You've got six teams with double game weeks in 35 to ponder over the assets from them. Like we said already, Villa with the only double game week of game week 34. However, they single the following week. So, yeah, just something to bear in mind. And obviously, then we've got that cheeky little game week they've slotted on at the end there for us for the FA Cup final and the Europa Conference League final if Villa progress. So, yeah, use the ticker and, yeah, get the best assets in you can. Right, so what are we saying for the top five transfers for this week then?
Well, like, so I think the best transfers, if you want to go down the defensive route, would probably be Konsa, maybe Cash. You know, they're standing out, aren't they, really? But you probably want to be looking a bit further up the field if you're in your mini leagues wanting to leapfrog anyone. So probably your attackers, wouldn't you say, boys?
Yeah, I think, like I said, Havertz is probably, out of anyone who isn't just being defaulted in there for having two games, which would only be the Villa players for this coming game week, Havertz. He's not in a huge percentage of teams, and he could be a really nice differential for this coming game week. I certainly fancy him to get some good points.
Yeah, Watkins as well, obviously, Villa, the only double game week team next week. Their leader man, currently joint third in the Golden Boot standings. Watkins, 19 for the season in the Premier League, 6.4 points per game. You know, if he's double game weekend, he's getting you close to 13 points on an average week, you know, so you can't really go wrong. If you've not got him in your team by now, then you've either given up playing or you're a bit slow on the uptake. So, yeah, get Watkins in. Isak, obviously, you know, on fire. He's on absolute fire at the moment. No-brainer, really. Double game week on the horizon in game week 35. Burnley away. Burnley fighting for points, so they're going to have to come out and be a little bit more expansive. Newcastle can pick teams off on the break so easy. He's rapid. I expect points and returns from Isak this weekend. So, yeah, one to really consider. And currently, yeah, joint third with Watkins for the Golden Boot, both on 19 for the season. So, yeah, they're going to be looking to notch more and more, because you know what these strikers are like? They love to score goals and they love to win prizes. So yeah, they'll be well aware of their standings in the Golden Boot. So what are we saying for the captains then, guys?
The old campaigners. KDB, obviously. Ridiculous points at the moment. He doesn't really stop scoring points. I think he's a decent shout. Like I said before, he's going to be one of your spine players. If you don't fancy doing something crazy, then you know you could be chucking him the armband to see how he gets on.
Yeah, I think Watkins is probably going to be the one, isn't he, that everybody goes to. I mean, like Adam said earlier on, he's got a good record against Brighton. I think it's 6-6 against Brighton now in total. So pretty impressive. Only one with the double game weeks. So why not? But again, yeah. Haaland, like you said, Haaland's got a good record against Wolves, hasn't he? So
yeah, Haaland with a very good record against Wolves. He'll be fairly well rested as well. You know, he's not played much football over the last few weeks. He'll be chomping at the bit. And City are just ticking over like a machine. They know what they've got to do. If they win every game, they win the league. You know, Pep's going to have them drilled on all the finest margins. I don't know if you boys have watched the Treble Winners documentary on Netflix about City, but like that dressing room, something else, really, yeah. Really special. You can see why they had such a successful season last year. And although Pep can be the most scary bastard, he's got them, and he's got them playing, and they'll run themselves into the ground for him. So Haaland definitely could be a huge differential shout for captaincy. You know, if he goes and scores a hat trick or four, and you know, Watkins, he has got the double game week, and he is playing against Brighton under 16s. But you know, who knows? Right. Well, there you go. Some tricky decisions this week. Me, I'm like 50 points behind Ross. Ross is sat at the top of the league. Rob's like 50 points behind me in third. So the three of us in our mini league, you know, apart from Ross, we're all looking to try and make ground. However, I think me and Ross have got nine players the same. Captain's choice is looking like everyone's going to go Watkins. What do you do if you need to make up ground? You need to find that fine margin, you know? So,
what do you do if you don't want to make up ground? You know, you grey it out. Well, that is the answer.
You grey it out.
And be prepared for me to grey it out.
Yeah. You'll be second-guessing all of our transfers.
you'll be going so mental, you end up doing something suicidal.
Crazy. Well, that is highly likely. That is highly likely.
That's the takeaway from this week. If you are doing well in your mini leagues, just grey it out, right?
Yeah.
Everyone's going to be Googling, what does grey out mean?
So, right. As we mentioned the other week, we've got a new Facebook page. Getting some traction there. A few of you have come along and joined us. New followers. Michael Williams, David Yates, Ben Fornley, Donna Dacry, Philip Robbins, Wayne Whitehead, and Andrew Neighbours. The link for the Facebook group will be posted in the description section on YouTube on the video. If you could head over there and give us a little like, give us a little follow, you know, that would be much appreciated. If you enjoyed the video, drop us a like on YouTube. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe on there as well. Rob, anything else?
Yeah, I'd just like to give a little shout out to our friend who sells new and old boots at r_our_football_boots on Instagram. He's got little samples for us to have a little look at. New preds. So
very nice.
Some more.
Big time.
Got some old ones, got some old classic retro. Look at these, like Ronaldo ones, like R9 ones. Look at them.
Cool.
Nice.
Very nice.
They're pretty cool.
He does well to send all these boots to you.
Well, he lives close by, so he just bends them to me. But yeah, check him out. He's got some good stuff on there. Send him a little DM. He'll get back to you.
Okay, well, cheers for that. All right. Well, tricky week. A few tricky decisions to make, as might want to be trying to move from a 3-5-2 to a 4-3-3. To a 3-4-3 or something along those lines. So as Ross mentioned, that midfield five is very difficult to find one to drop out. So tricky choices there. Tricky captain's choice if you need to try and find a differential. And I think we need to have one eye on game week 35 as well with our transfers for this week. So, yeah, one for us to ponder. Hope we've been a help. And thanks for your time. Thanks for viewing. Cheers, guys. Thanks for your time. Always good to have a chat with you about the footy and the dream team. All the best for the weekend, and we'll catch you next time here on Into Dream Team. And may the points be with you.
And with you.
It's the final countdown.